Das ist es. Christmas. We're going to kind of take you back through our semester a little bit. Before the football team showed us what they were going to do all year, I had intentions of doing a Halloween concert, and then they never lost, and they kept winning, and they kept winning, and they kept winning. So my idea of a Halloween concert was like, no. So if you notice, The concert is a little bit more different and varied, and you'll see. So there are your typical Christmas songs. There's one sort of Thanksgiving-ish. And then there's a full-out Halloween song. The Darkened Theater, you'll be fun with this. So the next piece on our concert is called We Wish You a Klezmer Christmas. We did this a few years ago, and I thoroughly fell in love with the piece. It is Christmas music set to the Jewish styles of dance and music. So it's not your typical Christmas piece, but it's not your typical Hanukkah piece. And it's just this weird mix, and I just love it, and I wanted to bring it back. And this group is the perfect group to do this with. So we wish you a Klezmer Christmas.
Thank you.
They're not leaving, I swear. I promise. So we try to keep skills going. We try to keep things moving through the year. We kind of joked, you know, we played 13 football games, 6 contests, a Veterans Day concert, homecoming parade. Pretty much we've not stopped. So tomorrow for us is going to be wonderful, except we have to get ready to go be Vanderbilt's pep band next week. We've done something right because this is the 4th year we've done it, and they like us, and we get our choice of days. So we're going next Tuesday night and televised game. Woo! I love that. So to keep skills kind of going, we're doing a percussion ensemble this year. Well, a percussion ensemble is great when you have percussion members that don't work or, you know, don't have a life outside of school, and you are still wanting to do something. So what you're about to hear is the current percussion ensemble, which only has 2 regular percussion players. There are flute players, clarinet players, a violin player, and percussion ensemble. So it's open to anybody. So what we're gonna do is, Miss Birmingham, who's not here tonight because she's actually in DeKalb County doing her own concert, she brought along this piece called Wizards in Winter, which is also a Trans-Siberian Orchestra piece, just like the first piece that we played. So I'm going to go back here and make sure that things go right, because I haven't seen it either. So I don't know what's about to happen. So this is called Wizards in Winter. Thank you. So I get very lucky. Every couple of years, I've been blessed to have a student teacher. And I'll explain Hannah here in a second. This is my fifth student teacher since I've been here. One of them is currently at Belmont getting a master's. One of them teaches at Stone Memorial. One of them teaches at one of the elementary schools up in Cumberland County. One is pursuing his lifelong dream of middle school band in Las Vegas. And he's kicking butt. He had his first concert last week. And he's all in now. It's great. And then this one showed up at my door this semester. I've actually known Hannah a little longer than she thinks, and I get to tell a story real quick, and it's a fast one. I met Hannah as a freshman at Tech as a tuba player, and we kind of looked at her and went, you might make something one day. This was 7 years ago. And through a bunch of things, if you want to know her history and her backstory, she'll tell you, or one of us will tell you, because there's a lot. The perseverance that she has went through is amazing. Last Friday, she graduated with a very, very high score on her CAT, which made me proud, absolutely proud. One thing that she is, though, is she is trying to be a professional tuba player. She has an audition with the U.S. Navy Band at the end of February. And somehow she landed here with us, and I am so happy. I am also very sad because I don't get to see her in January because she has to go do other things. So, Hannah Eisen, come here. This piece is called Sanctus. It's called Canon in D. It fits the kids. And it kind of fits the situation that we're about to have here, because it's not really a goodbye. It's a, I can't wait to see you next time. So we weren't going to let this happen. She wasn't, and then today she looked at me and said, hey, I want to conduct. I'm like, yes, you do. So I'm getting out of the way. Ms. Eisen, have fun. Okay, I'm gonna try to get two things done at once while not crying. she fit in way too well. And it, you know, it's just, it's hard to, it's good to see them be who they are and how they can do. But at the same time, it's going to be hard watching her go away. So I have two things. First, if you look at your program on the back, on the roster, you'll see where it's marked as all mid-state. We had students this year that went down to the Murfreesboro, Antioch area, and Lebanon area, and auditioned for mid-state. First of all, I would like for everyone that's on a saxophone who's standing up, I would like for everybody who auditioned for mid-state, no matter which grade it was, to stand up. Now, don't get sit back down, because I know some of you don't like being embarrassed this much. Tommy Jacobs, over there. Tommy made his second time getting into mid-state on jazz guitar. He beat out almost everybody on jazz guitar except for one sophomore. One. So Tommy knocked out a bunch of juniors and seniors, and I was really cool with that. So there you go, Tommy. That's you too. Jilly, come back out here. Where you at? There you are. Jilly, as a freshman, made the 9-10 band in the silver band, and maybe this is her second year in a row. And it's very difficult to make it in the 9-10 group that first time. And she got in, so I'm very proud of her. Mariano. Mariano had to make the jump from the 9-10 band to the 11-12 band, so he had to play up this year, and he also made it in. This is his second consecutive year of making it. All right. Emma, stand up. This is Emma's fifth year making this tape. So I take these guys in January back to Murfreesboro, and they sit in a band for basically 2.5 days, play a concert, then they never see each other again. So they show up on Thursday night, they start rehearsing, they rehearse twice or three times on Friday, and then Saturday they give a concert at MTSU, and then they're done. And that band never exists again. So that's a weird thing, but it's, for us, it's a special thing. I mean, Mid-State is not easy to get into. Now, there's one thing that's not on there, and y'all didn't know I was gonna do this. Tennessee Tech, every year in November, holds a symposium. And any student from sophomore up, except for one, because we kind of snuck some things in this year. They get to go and be taught by these professors at Tech. So, wait till you see this. Everybody who went to symposium this year, stand up. We had the most students by far. We had 30 make it. 30 of our 60. So that was incredible. And now, here's the other thing, because the saxophone's entire standing there. If you were here for our spring concert, you got to hear one of our students, Jake McAbee, have an arrangement done, and he got to conduct his piece in front of you. Well, it's happened again. Except now, Gage Weber, instead of using the whole band, said, I just need saxophones. So this is beginning to look a lot like Christmas, reimagined from Michael Bublé's version, correct? Yeah. Into Gage Weber's version. So you want to talk about it, or you want to? I'm done talking.
Hi, good evening. So how I got this idea was that back in the summer, I went to Tennessee Tech's Music Summer Institute. And so you go there for a week, you take master classes, you learn about your instrument, and most of all, you perform with your section. So I went on Barry Sax, so I performed with the saxophone. So Dr. Matthew Gunthorpe, the assistant professor of saxophones at Tennessee Tech, made us perform a saxophone quartet piece. It was a Christmas piece. It was Simple Gifts by Ticelli, and oh my God, it was so good. So when I came back to school in August, I was like, I was brewing up ideas. And so I was like, I want to do this again. I couldn't find the piece. I would have bought it. I would have bought it and put it to these guys, but I couldn't find it. And so I was like, if I can't find it, I'm just going to make it myself. So I arrange, it's beginning to look like a lot like Christmas by Michael Bublé. It took me about 2 weeks to a month to completely finish it. And in our rehearsals, I'm very happy with the progress we've made with just these four people. So I hope you guys enjoy. This is the official Upperman High School Saxophone Quartet.
I love it when the kids come to me and go, can we try this? I'm like, yes. Yes. I don't ever want a kid to look at me and say, can I do this? And I look at them and go, no, that's not teaching. That's not educating. That's not getting this kind of response for these guys. So we're going to give these guys just a second to kind of get everything back together. Yeah, I'm going to wait. I'm going to be mean. So I know, Mr. Robbins, I saw you. You're there. Mr. King, are you here? There you are. I see you. Ladies and gentlemen, these two men have no clue what they did when they got me here. And I'm going to continue to keep that going. So whatever we need to do to keep this running, thank those two. Thank them greatly. I have stayed before in concerts, and I truly believe this. This is easily the best place I have ever worked. And guys, I have worked in some strange places. I lived in Kentucky. It ain't just basketball, but it almost is. So the next piece on our concert, this is Music for a Darkened Theater. This is all Danny Elfman music, which is the Tim Burton movies. So if you like Edward Scissorhands, if you like The Nightmare Before Christmas, this is what we're playing. So here we go, Music for a Darkened Theater.
Thank you.
Sad part I have to do. I have seniors who are graduating this week, and tonight's their final concert. So I need my seniors who are going to leave me this week to stand up. Percussion will all squat for Lydia there. Graduating is never easy, and trying to get the band to, you know, go to the next year and figure things out, it's never easy. It's really, really difficult when you lose them in between. So, for the two of you, I say, this is your home, and the door is open. Never forget where the family is, and when you need it, come back to it. Okay? Except for jail, I will not bail you out. I'm on a
salary.
No such thing. Okay, I ain't got that cash. Okay? That's part one. Part two, I'm not conducting the last piece because it's not my piece to conduct. It really isn't. 6 years ago, when the call went out that this position was going to happen, I found out very quickly about it, and I jumped on it very fast, because a lot of you that don't know, Mr. Netherton and myself, we actually not only went to TAC together, which puts us as old, we actually taught, my first 2 years of teaching were with him in Gallatin. So this has all come full circle for us. And every year that I get the opportunity to just hang out with him and do things, and, you know, 3 years ago, chase him. Now, 3 years later, he's chasing me. If you see our running, you understand. Guys, I would have never been here if it wasn't for these guys and him. So it is only fair that I pass the band to him for tonight. And we end our concert, as we end it every year, with Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas. So I present to you the high school band with Mr. Kyle Netherton. Thank you. So we thank you for things. We thank parents, if you don't understand the love we have for you, everything y'all done this semester, this year, I can't begin to thank you more. And we just, everything you do is amazing. So we thank you. Guys, have a great Christmas. Have a Merry Christmas. Students, have a good midterms. Y'all drive safe. We will see you later. Thank you.